for tuning into Mirror Now. You're watching the news with me, Avni Raja. Delhi Police's OMG moment. SHO offers his own chair to self-styled godwoman Radhe Ma. Red-faced force acts swiftly, shuns out officer and five other cops. Shocking lapses in security led to the murder of 7-year-old Pradyum Thakur in a Gurugram school. CBSC files its affidavit in the Supreme Court, reiterates the negligence of Ryan school authorities. Massive turnout in Raj Thackeray-led MNS Mega Dhadak Mahamorcha. Thousands of MNS workers marched on the streets of Mumbai. MNS chief threatens violence if demands of better railway infrastructure are not met. First, she was forced to bite off her rapist's ear to save herself. Then Uttar Pradesh cops humiliate her, accusing her of making false accusations. Police refuse Aligarh rape survivor an FIR. Two teenage sisters gang raped by three men in a Jharkhand school. Entire incident was filmed. Police have identified the three youths, but no arrests yet. Man batters his wife to death in Gaya in Bihar. Her fault? She gave birth to a baby girl. Brutal murder reported by the woman's elder daughter. The infant was the couple's fifth child. Dr. Virendra Tavre, key accused in the Narendra Dabolkar murder case, denied bail by Pune Sessions Court. Under the scanner for the murder of two activists, the CBI counsel opposed Tavre's bail plea on grounds that he could tamper with crucial evidence. Mirror Now's campaign, Make Our Locals Safe, continues. Today, we get you ground reports from three different stations on the central line that need urgent attention. Even before winter sets in, Delhi's air quality dips to poor. Ground check reveals the capital is not prepared again this year to combat air pollution. It's a major embarrassment for the Delhi police. Controversial self-styled godwoman Radhe Ma was given a celebrity welcome at Vivek Vihar police station. Delhi police has taken prompt action and initiated an inquiry into the incident where Radhe Ma is seen receiving VVIP welcome and seen singing songs along with other police officers. Now, two of the policemen, including the SHO Sanjay Sharma, have been suspended. Remember, earlier in the day, six policemen were stripped off their posts. This, of course, came after the video surfaced of Radhe Ma singing with the policemen at the Vivek Vihar station.
In what can be dubbed as a big embarrassment there for the Delhi police, the SHO of Delhi's Vivek Vihar area was seen according a celebrity welcome to self-styled godwoman Radhe Ma inside the police station. In fact, this entire matter came on the 28th of September, where the video and the photos of the same matter went viral on social media. And this is the very police station where this took place. And you can see in those pictures and the fact that Radhe Ma is being seated on the chair of the SHO while the SHO is standing next to her. In a video that also went viral, it can be seen how five police officials who've been identified as police officials from the GTB Enclave Police Station were seen dancing and singing along with Radhe Ma at a Ram Leela event. And it's understood that Radhe Ma had come to Delhi on the 28th of September to attend this event. Now, since it has been a big embarrassment there for the Delhi police, a disciplinary action has been initiated for gross misconduct, and all these erring officials have been sent to district lines. Now, while an inquiry has been initiated, Special Commissioner Dipender Pathak has called it absolutely unfortunate and unacceptable, saying that stern action will be taken based on the findings of the inquiry report, which will be submitted to the Commissioner of Police by the DCP Shahadra. In New Delhi, this is Apurva Sridhar for Mirror Now.
Now, the Delhi police submitted an inquiry report, and two policemen, including the SHO of Vivek Vihar and the ASI, have been suspended with immediate effect.
Actually, the conduct was found unprofessional, and that is the reason why the inquiry was ordered and he has been sent to district line. And we are going to see in that report, in that inquiry, we'll see in what circumstances the chair was given to her and what was the reason and what actually happened. That was important to know to take strict action. Before taking that, it was important to conduct an inquiry.
It came to notice through media that there is an unprofessional conduct on the part of one SHO and a few policemen in the Shahdara district of Delhi. So prima facie, the conduct has been found unprofessional. So the SHO has been sent to lines, and along with the SHO, the two ASIs, two head constables and one constable, so they also have been sent to district lines. And the additional deputy commissioner of the district is conducting an inquiry which has been instituted to go into the details and nuances and the circumstances which led to this unprofessional conduct, and based on the inquiry report, further action will be taken against these policemen.
Time now to take a look at what else is making news across the nation. An elderly couple who claimed to be actor Dhanush's biological parents have now filed a complaint against the actor. The couple from Madurai had earlier this year filed a plea at the Madras High Court claiming that Dhanush was their child who had gone missing. The High Court had dismissed the case. The couple now alleges that Dhanush submitted fake certificates and documents to the court. Jayalalitha's niece Deepa and nephew Deepak are facing more issues. Tamil Nadu's Revenue Department officials have refused to issue legal heir certificates to them. Deepa and Deepak have been advised to approach the court in this matter. Kerala Chief Minister P. Vijayan has retaliated to Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath's comments that Kerala should take lessons from UP's healthcare system. Vijayan retorted that CPM will never bow down to the financial might of the RSS and its affiliates. He added that Yogi should take his comments back. A BJP corporator was tied to a tree and thrashed by residents of Navi Nagri locality in Vadodara. The residents were allegedly unhappy with the housing provided to them after their slum was demolished. A video of the incident went viral on social media. Another incident of Gundaraj from Uttar Pradesh. A BJP worker, Deepak, was shot by an unidentified man in the area that falls under the Majola police station area of Moradabad district. The Madurai bench of the Madras High Court dismissed rebel AIADMK leader TTV Dinakaran's plea, seeking the court's direction to grant more time for the Election Commission to submit affidavits on the two leaves symbol. In a heartwarming video, few men tried to save a dog from an overflowing drain. Despite people asking them not to risk their lives, the men formed a human chain and continued their rescue efforts. They were later applauded for their efforts after managing to save the dog. An elderly couple was crushed to death by a bus on the Mysore Road flyover on Tuesday while they were trying to navigate around a pothole. Another couple, Pavitra and George, also fell victim to the same killer pothole. Thankfully, they survived, but they sustained serious injuries. The criminal apathy of authorities didn't end there. The police forced them to run from pillar to post when they tried to register an FIR against the Bengaluru civic body. In fact, they tried to even hush up the matter, calling it a hit-and-run accident. And now they are being pestered to bring eyewitnesses to the accident in order to corroborate their statement. In fact, Mirror Now accompanied Pavitra and George when they went to the police station to file a complaint and witnessed the harassment firsthand. First, they were made to wait for 2.5 hours for registering an FIR. Then they were told to bring witnesses to prove that this wasn't a hit-and-run accident. Listen in to what they had to tell us yesterday.
Then 7 o'clock, 6:30, na wagi do. Chamrajpur traffic police orge. Na first ಇದ್ದಾದ್ರ ಚಿಕ್ಕಪೇಟೆ ಪೊಲೀಸ್ ಸ್ಟೇಷನ್ ಆದ್ರೆ ಅವರು ನಮ್ಮದು ಇದು ಇಲ್ಲ, ಇದು ನಮಗೆ ಜಾಗ ಬರಲ್ಲ, ಇದು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಚಾಮರಾಜಪೇಟೆ ಪೊಲೀಸ್ ಸ್ಟೇಷನ್ಗೆ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಇದು ಟ್ರಾಫಿಕ್ ಪೊಲೀಸ್ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ, ನಮ್ಮ ಇನ್ಚಾರ್ಜಿಗೆ ಬರಲ್ಲ, ಇದು ನೀವು ಅಷ್ಟು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗಿ ಕಂಪ್ಲೇಂಟ್ ಕೊಡಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು. ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ ನಾವು 6:15 ನಾವು ಅಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಬಂದು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕಂಪ್ಲೇಂಟ್ ತೊಗೊಳಂದ್ರು ಅಂದರೆ ಇಲ್ಲ ನಮ್ಮ ಇನ್ಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ರ್ ಬರಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್ ಈ ಥರ ಆಗಿದೆ ಇನ್ಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ರ್ ಯಾವಾಗ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಸರಿ ಆಯ್ತು ಬನ್ನಿ ಅಂತ ಕಂಪ್ಲೇಂಟ್ ತೊಗೊಂಡ್ರು.
ಸೊ ಎಷ್ಟೊತ್ತು ವೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಸ್ತಿದ್ರು
ಅವರು? 2 hours ವೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು, 2 hours ವೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಸಿದ್ರು. ನಮಗೆ ತುಂಬ ಪೇಯ್ನ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಸರ್, ನಾವು ಹೋಗ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಆಗೋಯ್ತು ಆಗೋಯ್ತು ಅಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಹಂಗೂ 2.5 hours ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು, ವೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕೇಳೋದಕ್ಕೆ ನಮಗೆ ಬರಲ್ಲ, ನಾವು ಏನಿದ್ರು ವೈಟ್ ಡ್ರೆಸ್ನವರು ಬರೀ ಟ್ರಾಫಿಕ್ ಮಾತ್ರ, ನಮ್ಮದು ಅದು BBMP ಕಂಪ್ಲೇಂಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲ, ನಾವು ತಗೊಳ್ಳಲ್ಲ, ನೀವು ಪೊಲೀಸ್ ಸ್ಟೇಷನ್ಗೆ ಹೋಗಿ ಕಂಪ್ಲೇಂಟ್ ಕೊಡಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಸರಿ ಅಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ನಾವು ಇವಾಗ ಬಂದಿದ್ದೀವಿ.
It's been 3 days and 3 different cases have come to light where citizens have suffered on account of potholed streets. When Miranau confronted the Bengaluru civic body, they claimed they were already doing the best that they could and that nothing more can be done during the monsoons. Now we understand it has been raining torrentially for the last 6 hours and there is heavy waterlogging on arterial roads.
Right now, standing at town hall, what you can see is it's still drizzling at this point in time. In fact, the rain started here in Bengaluru at around 1 p.m. and it was at a stretch. It went on for a stretch of about 5 hours, and we could see some of the low-lying areas, especially Shantinagar Double Road, Kormangla, Madiwala and Hebbal flyover was completely inundated. You could see there was no space for water to in fact seep in through the ground. Also remember that over the last couple of weeks we have seen how Bengaluru has been completely failing. The infrastructure is completely crumbling only because of the rains. Also, KJ George, Bengaluru Development Minister, had promised the citizens of Bengaluru, saying in the first week of October they will be deploying in fact robotic excavators, and still we are awaiting for that. We don't see that work on ground, that is robotic excavators. They have allocated at least about 300 crores only for this robotic excavator so that they can start with the cleaning and dredging of the stormwater drains. Remember that ideally this work should have started like at least 6 months ago during summer, but unfortunately our government is taking up the work only when it is raining, and it is a huge mess here in the city where you can see in fact normal life has been completely thrown out of gear. People are in fact losing lives because of the pothole, and the reason for the pothole is only because of the rain. Now you can question clearly the government, the shoddy work by the government itself. Also we see the stormwater drains overflowing. All these areas, the low-lying areas in Bengaluru city, is completely flooded. We also saw at least more than 3 to 4 trees being uprooted. That again, the responsibility falls on the BBMP, while they should have conducted a tree census, but clearly nothing has been really done, and Bengaluru is completely failing because the civic authority has failed to do their job.
Shifting focus now, 1 month ago, journalist Gauri Lankesh was brutally murdered outside her house. The special investigation team looking into the case claims it has some clues, yet there has been no headway. A candlelight vigil was held in Bengaluru demanding justice for the slain journalist.
Over 100 people from various walks of life, especially representing the Forum for Assassination Against Gauri Lankesh, have descended here at this spot in Town Hall in Bengaluru to protest against the government for failing to in fact nab the killers. Remember, it's been a month and there have been no concrete evidence. You can clearly see them carrying the placards and shouting slogans against the government. Clearly, you can see this particular placard which reads, "Mr. Modi, why are you silent?" And also you have another placard which reads, "In the wake of brutal murder of journalist activist Gauri Lankesh, voice against silencing dissent." Now these are the kind of placards that you clearly see how people have come here to protest and condemn the murder of Gauri Lankesh. Remember that it's been almost a month. Still now we understand that there have been no leads or no arrests made as far as this particular case is concerned, and we did see how the family members of Gauri Lankesh did come out in the open and address the media, saying that they want to give more time, though they are very unhappy with the ongoing investigation. They want to give some more time for the SIT officers to crack the mystery murder. Now remember that we also hear from the SIT SIT officers, they have already sent the images, which in fact the CCTV camera which captured the entire crime incident, to a digital lab in the United States. And that apart, we understand also they are in fact questioning the family members, associates and friends of Gauri Lankesh. But so far we understand there is no substantial evidence in fact to zero in on culprits, and the investigation is still on despite a month. In Bengaluru, Shrija for Mirror Now.
Protests were also held outside the Mumbai Press Club. Amita Balachandra sent us this report.
In time from Marine Drive in the city of Mumbai, several citizens have gathered together to mark their protest, really saying that their voices cannot be silenced and they will continue to protest until these journalists who were attacked get justice. Amita Balachandra for Mirror Now. We have with us Ratna Pathak right now. Ma'am, thank you so much for joining us. First of all, there is a huge chain of protests here that I'm seeing, and I'm looking at the pen that you have, which says, I am Gauri. But tell us, what are your comments on the recent spate of attacks that we've seen on journalists?
They have been terribly depressing. This is not the India I know. This is certainly not the India my parents were trying to build. It is not the India that I had dreams for. This is a strange India. And it's a frightening India, but I don't think we can afford to be frightened, because if we don't speak up, our children are the ones who are going to suffer.
I'm just talking to young people, young journalists as well, who said that their spirits are not dampened. What is your message to them?
Yes, my spirit is not dampened either. There are young people who are willing to stand up with me, or if I can stand with them, I'm going to be there too.
On September 23rd, students of Banaras Hindu University demanding security on campus were lathi charged. The UP government and campus administration offered the customary assurances, but nothing has changed on ground. In fact, another girl has been molested on campus, and this time while a team from the Women's Commission was present there. The MA second year girl student was molested, dragged by her hair and manhandled on the campus by a student of the Public Administration Department. And ironically, all this while the NCW team was on campus questioning the officials over the security that is offered to students. The accused has now been arrested.
At a time when a three-member team of the NCW is in the Banaras Hindu University to probe the allegations of harassment, eve-teasing and the police force that was used at the students inside the campus, another shocking incident of harassment is coming to light from inside the campus. Another girl there molested inside the campus, while the accused in this case has been arrested. This has certainly raised a lot of questions and has validated the kind of demands that the students inside the campus have been making regarding better security, installation of CCTV cameras and better lighting, and have been raising their voice against repeated cases of molestation happening inside the campus. The big question still remains, how much longer do these students have to wait till the BHU administration takes note of the kind of instances that are taking inside the campus? In New Delhi, this is Apurva Sridhar for Mirror Now.
All right, shifting focus now. Mirror Now has not forgotten the promises made by our netas and civic body authorities. We will keep asking for our right, safe train travel. To initiate this, we bring you our special campaign, where in a series of reports from across Mumbai, we will expose the reality that is on ground. And today we bring you reports from three stations on the Central Railway line, and each one of them are plagued by the same issue that led to the stampede at Elphinstone Station: narrow overbridges and single exit points. Aditya Tiwari visited the Chinchpokli Railway Station and found out just how bad the situation is there. Take a look.
Right now we are standing at Chinchpokli Railway Station. This comes under Central Railway. And here you can see that this Chinchpokli Railway Station is the busiest railway station, but this station has only 1 foot overbridge. As you can see that this bridge width is very narrow, and in the peak hours, like in the rush hours in the morning and the evening time, this bridge gets fully jammed, packed, and people face lots of struggle to go through this bridge. And you can see that this is one of the busiest railway station, and as you can see, see over here that the there's only one bridge over here, one footover bridge, and very narrow footover bridge. People on a daily basis face lots of struggle over here. They fear that after the stampede that that happened in Elphiston, even they fear that this might happen over here as well. This is not the only one problem over here. Even the ticket counters that has been made on this bridge remains mostly closed. And when we arrived over here, the railway ticket counter was closed. And after some time, when they saw the media pressure, they opened that railway counter. People often complain regarding this, but there's nothing happening on the positive side. As you can see that this bridge is so narrow that even in the morning time, if a crowd of 1,000 also comes, then this bridge gets fully packed. Central government and the railway authorities need to make one more bridge that should have one to two exits, because there is only one exit and three entrance. So this can happen anytime. An accident can occur in this railway station anytime. In Mumbai, this is Aditya Tiwari for Mirror Now.
This ticket window, they shut this thing like in the afternoon, mm-hmm. and they give the reason as lunch break, but if lunch break, then how will people take tickets, you know? Yeah, even the card is not working like in this machine.
कभी भी आएगा टिकट निकालो को टिकट नहीं मिलता जल्दी पास निकालो का पास नहीं मिलता है कभी वो बंद रहता है बहुत होती है ना क्या करेगा लेकिन दो एक ट्रेन एकदम आएगा तो उतरने को नहीं मिलता चढ़ने को नहीं होता ये इधर बहुत नैरो भेजा है उसका आगे है थोड़ा बड़ा है लेकिन ये बहुत नैरो भेजा है
Curry Road Railway Station has the same problem. The footover bridge which connects the road and the station is dilapidated, so much so that during rush hour, commuters often sense tremors on the bridge. The construction of another footover bridge began 3 years ago, but there is no progress that is visible.
ज़्यादा अगर बारिश अगर कुछ होता है और शॉर्ट सर्किट होता है तो आदमी को बाहर नहीं जा सकता और अंदर भी नहीं इतना तकलीफ हो सकता है लोगों को कि ये जो एल्फिंस्टन का हादसा उससे भी डबल ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा हादसा यहाँ करूर स्टेशन पे हो जाएगा आज जो ब्रिज के नीचे स्टेशन पे जो ब्रिज का काम चल रहा है वो स्टेशन का पीछे काम कम से कम मैं देख रहा हूँ 4 साल से ऐसा ही चल रहा है जो काम 6 महीने का है उसको 4 साल क्यों लग रहा है ये लोगों का और ऐसा हादसा होना चाहिए कि और ऐसा हादसा होने के बाद आपको खाली अनुदान देगा तो आपका काम हो गया क्या रेलवे लोगों का काम हो गया क्या सरकार का काम हो गया क्या
ये अभी से नहीं यार 25 बरस से हो रहा है मेरा जिंदगी का 25 बरस इधर गया है 25 बरस से ऐसा ही हो रहा है आप एक दिन है ना एक दिन सुबह 8:30 से 10:30 बजे से ये करियो स्टेशन पे आके जाओ यार उधर क्या रश होता है देखो
Mirror Now also ventured out to Thane local station to take stock of the situation. Thane station has 10 platforms, but just 3 footover bridges to cater to the 10 lakh strong footfall of commuters daily. My colleague Disha Shah visited the railway station during peak hours, and here's what she found out.
Thane railway station is also considered as one of the most crowded railway stations here and I'm standing here on the footover bridge and if I can ask my camera person to zoom in, this is the kind of crowd and passenger traffic that Thane sees almost every single day, almost 10 lakh passengers daily and every day more than 1200 trains pass through Thane which has 10 platforms catering to 2 corridors each for the fast and the slow tracks and the trans Harbour Link as many as in fact more than 60 trains also travel to the longer distances which only adds up to the passengers here and in fact as you can see this is one of the busiest railway station here when it comes to handling the footover bridges in fact an additional bridge was also considered if I can ask my camera person to zoom it but not many as you can see use this bridge because they are far off from the platforms. In fact, when we spoke to the commuters here who travel on the daily basis, what they say is that this kind of a traffic and this kind of heavy passenger movement is witnessed and observed every now and then.
With that, it's a wrap on this edition of the news. Thanks for watching and stay tuned to Mirror Now.